The one thing about me is that no matter how it is, even if you don't love the subject, I'll make you love the subject. So look at this comment. Some candidates do not understand the question due to poor command of English language, such as could not write correct answers. They even copied incorrectly words that were on the question paper. What?
What's up, guys? Pat is my name, and Justice Computing Class is the best.
Hello, my lovely students. I hope you're all doing well. I welcome you all back to Justice Computing Class. My name is Justice Joseph Kofi Kabe, an ICT educator. Today, we are going to look at Chief Examiner's Report. We've already solved the BEC questions. That's for 2011. So the Chief Examiner's Report on the that paper, we're going to look at some of the comments, strengths and weaknesses on that very paper. Then we'll see how best we'll look at it and see so that we apply them when you're answering ICT questions. It is very important to advise your student to watch this channel so that they can understand the Chief Examiner's Report so that they can apply them. And it's always advisable too that you should read the Chief Examiner's Report to your student so that they will understand how WAEC mark the ICT papers. It's really, really important. So if today's your first time of watching on your screen, I advise that you subscribe to my YouTube channel and also share, like, so that we can grow the family of computing. Yeah, so without wasting much time, I want us to move straight to the Chief Examiner's Report. So Chief Examiner's Report for 2011. So let's read the Chief Examiner's Report. So on your screen, as you can see, so information and communication technology, technology general comments. So listen very well. So we are going to look at the general comments. We are going to look at the summary of candidate strength. Then we are going to look at summary of candidate weaknesses. Then we'll look at the suggested remedies. Then we'll also look at details comments. Then I think we can leave it over there. So please kindly follow me every step that I take. So if you are not clear with something, kindly leave your questions under the comment section below so that I will explain them for you to understand more to become a better IT student. So the general comments. General comments. The question set were of standard and within the scope of the syllabus. This was the first information and communication technology taken by the junior high school student in Ghana. So we're saying that the question was set within the scope of the syllabus, and it was the first paper or first ICT question that was written in the year 2011. And the standard of the paper and the candidate performance could therefore not be compared to any previous ones, which means that we don't have any paper because it was the first year. We can't compare it to any other year. Yeah, but we wrote it in 2010. So the 2011, they did better than 2010, or 2010 did better, or it was good and was average or excellent. And so there's no other year to compare this year because it was the first paper that was written. So that's for that one. The general performance of the candidate was average. So average is not good. So the general performance of this candidate was what? Average. So because the first year, maybe the student don't really understand before writing the BC, so we end up by getting average. Now, a few performed excellently, especially candidates from schools that had computers and had both practicals and theory lessons under the good ICT teachers. So this, you realize that if you are not having a good ICT teacher and the ICT teacher too is not taking you through practicals, you will not perform well. So those who help us to get this average is those teachers who took them taught their lesson in both practicals and theory. So some schools, however, did not perform satisfactorily, probably because they did not have access to computers for ICT lessons. Indications are that candidates would perform better when exposed to computers and good tuition in computer studies. So we realized that some of the schools that didn't perform well are not having computers, are not available, computers are not accessible to the student to use. So they really indicate that candidates will perform better when they are exposed to what? Computers and good tuition in computer studies. So when you teach well, definitely your students will get grade one. So you realize that it is really important to do practicals when you are teaching ICT in school. So it's not about theory, but it is important for you to do practicals so that when you teach the theory, the practicals will print the whatever you teach, so that you print them into their mind or that will apply it. It is very important. So when, even when they go to the exam or they forget, the practical aspects will help them to apply what you taught them in the class. So now let's look at a summary of candidates' strengths. So now the first one is, the performance of candidate was appreciably average, as it was the first ICT examination at the junior school level. Still, they still have it because they believe that it's their first time of writing ICT, so it was average, their first time. So, two, questions on the identification of WordPad application program, steps involved in switching on the personal computer system, identification of some of the ICT tools, classification of hardware into input devices and devices which are basic to understanding ICT were satisfactorily answered by majority of the candidates. So which means that when we were solving the past questions, realized that there were some like input devices, identification of WordPad and all that. They said the candidate did very well answering those questions. So these are some of the things that they really did well in it. The candidate who performed creditably well gave concise answers to questions. This type of answers to questions should be encouraged. So which means that candidates gave simple answers when they were answering ICT questions. So they say we should encourage them to give such answers in the exam hall. Candidate also used the correct ICT terms in their responses and exhibited adequate understanding of ICT. I'll read this one again. Candidate also used the correct ICT terms in their responses and exhibited adequate understanding of ICT. So when you are teaching a child to learn, you are teaching a child ICT, you have to make sure that the child understands the ICT. He knows what ICT is. Provide answers to the examiner to prove to the examiner that yes, you really know what you are writing. Do you understand? You don't write your answer somehow, anyhow, to expect. Really, I've read me myself. I'm examining myself. I mark scripts. So when you know that a child can just pass, like can just write a sentence simple or the definition simple, the child will pass some way to end up by getting that, which is very bad. Simple answers, straight answers for you to get your answers. Are you okay? Candidate is supposed to give a straight answer. So WAEC is recommending students who have adequate understanding of what the ICT. Now let's look at summary of weakness. That's my area that I really, really want to read, because these areas are things that there are areas that will help the child or the candidate to make sure he understands or refuse to commit some of the mistakes that their seniors commit. So one, some candidates appear to have been inadequately prepared for the ICT exam, as they showed lack of knowledge in the ICT. So they go to the exam hall, they can't write anything on the paper. They can't write anything. So it's like they are not prepared, they don't have any knowledge about the paper. You understand? They have knowledge about even how to call up row, nothing. So please, these are some of the things. So please, teachers, kindly take note of this one. Make sure that you teach the child all areas so that when they go to the exam hall, they should have something to write on. The next one, questions on spreadsheet were not satisfactorily answered by most candidates as performance in that aspect of the paper was marginal. So that most people couldn't answer questions on spreadsheet application. So which means that the last part of the question 5, the cell, columns, range and all that, they were not able to answer it. What is spreadsheet, types of spreadsheet, they were not able to answer it. But based on the 2011 question, it was cell, column, range, and the how do you call it, row. They were not able to answer it. Then three, some candidates did not understand the question due to poor commands of English language, such as candidate could not write correct answers. They even copy incorrectly words that were on the question paper. Seriously? So you can see that if you don't develop the courage, like the confidence in the student before going to the exam hall, you end up by failing. The student will end up by failing. The one thing about me is that no matter how it is, even if you don't love the subject, I'll make you love the subject. So look at this comment. Some candidates do not understand the question due to poor command of English language, such as could not write correct answers. They even copied incorrectly words that were on the question paper. What? Even the question, just copy the question to this mistake in it. So if you are teaching them, you have to teach them mature, like you should train them to have a matured mind. They should have a matured mind that they should respond maturely. That's how I behave. That's how I do teaching. I'll make sure that you behave like me. You behave maturely like me. That's all. So anytime when you come to my class, I always challenge them. Even as you have to know it at all costs. So if a student exam, a candidate should go to the exam hall and even question that you're even copying, that you're copying wrongly. There's question mark. Please, teachers, this one is on you. This comment is always on you, because if you're not doing your work well, at the end of the day, the result will bounce back to you. So please take note of these ones. Then the next one. It was apparently in some instances that some schools did not have access to computers for their lessons. Candidates from such schools were at disadvantage, and this showed in their work. So please, if you are a teacher and you are not teaching with practicals, you can have all the, you can be a guru in IT, but if you don't add practicals to it, forget it. Forget it. Seriously, forget it. Me, I teach, I have more theory and I have more practicals. Do you understand? So please, if look at this, some of the candidates, some school did not have access to computers for their lesson. Candidates from such schools were at a disadvantage, and it showed in their work. So which means that if you don't teach them the practical aspects, there's no way they can apply. Because me, when I teach theory, I teach practicals. Because if you should forget the theory, what I taught you, definitely the practicals will remind you of what to write. Do you understand? So please, teachers, always remember to take them through the practical aspects of. So that's the end of the weaknesses of some of the candidates. Now let's look at suggested remedies. Some of the things that we believe the right thing we should do to improve upon the performance of the students. So some of the suggested remedies are: one, schools must acquire computers for their students, since ICT is a practical course. Voila. So please, schools that are not having computers, why are you saying that you should what? Get the school or the student computers, laptops, because ICT is a practical course. Candidate cannot get adequate knowledge in ICT and perform well in examination without access to computers. It's correct. So there's no way they will perform well without them having a practical asset, or without them using computer, without them having a feeling or touching computers, seeing the part of the computer, mouse, keyboard. Do you understand? So please, teachers, this remedies and this how do you call it, weaknesses, though it came from the side of the student, but most of it comes from with the teachers because of the way we teach them. So please, let's take note of that one too. Then the second one, teachers in schools must lay emphasis equally on both theoretical and practical aspects of ICT. Yes, teachers in schools must lay emphasis equally on both theoretical and practical aspects of ICT. You have to. When you come to my class, pressure upon pressure, because I know how ICT questions, how it will trick you and at the end of the day you fall for the trick and you get zero. So if you can, anytime you see that I'm on them, no, you're supposed to do it this way. No, why could not accept this? No, why could not do this? Why could not mark this word correctly? Please change this. This term that you've written in this sentence over here or this definition is wrong. Why could not accept it? Why could mark it? Will give you half of five. So you see all these things, both theory and practicals. Both theory and practicals. So that's how ICT must be taught in our schools. Then the next one. Equal attention must be given to all topics in the ICT syllabus. Teachers like running away from topics. Teachers like running away from topic, and it is true. Realize that no, this topic I treat it well. I love this topic, and this one no. So instead of them taking their time to treat all the topic equally, you see that you take this one nicely, but when you get to you, instead of that topic supposed to be treated in first term, you take that topic to third term, last topic. Really? That topic is supposed to be treated first term, but you take that topic to third term, last topic. So at the end of the day, it will end up that you will not even treat that topic at all because time was not at your end. So even sometimes they even treat it, but not to into detail whereby the student will understand. Go and read on your own. Really, ICT, you can't tell the student that you go and read on your own. What I do is that I will teach you and tell you to go and apply. And come and tell me what you experience. That's how I do my teaching. So if I'm doing well in my ICT field, it's not that I'm that good, but you have to involve the student. When you teach the theory, tell them to go and apply this on their computers at home. When they come, they should come and tell you what they experience. If there's some of them would go, oh, uncle, or oh, say, I don't understand. When I did it, I couldn't arrive at what you told me to get. So please, then you have to see the person. So you are creating that kind of anxiety or that kind of courage for them to love the topic ICT. Are you okay? Then the next one, candidates must also improve their standard in writing of English language. Some candidates could not comprehend the question and were also not able to express themselves in English language. We always say that English language is the basis of every language, every subject, which is true. Social studies, RME, BDT, ICT, English itself, award our people and all that, all topics, English language. So if you're a student that you cannot express yourself, you can read and understand, then at the end of the day there will be problem for you in the exam hall. So please, candidate must also improve in their standard of writing. Your handwriting, me, the one in J1, I will not wait for you to come to J3 before I start working on you. I'll start working on you from J1, J2. So when we come to J3 and start writing your mocks, I know that you are okay. If you're not okay, I'll keep on working on it till you write your exam. And the pressure I'll be putting on you, the student yourself, no one will advise you to change. The pressure alone that I'll be putting on you, you will change yourself because you know that I'll keep on repeating one thing, whatever. I'll not give up on you. I'll keep on repeating whatever I have to do. I'll repeat it till you change, then I'll stop. If you start another one, I'll start all over again. That's who I am. I don't give up on students. So please, teachers, don't give up on, oh, this kid is not good in ICT. Oh, this person is good in it, so let me focus on this person. No, we have to make sure that we apply equality, make sure that you treat all of them equally. If they should go and they pass for you, glory. If they should go and some of them should pass and some of them shouldn't pass, because maybe you didn't take some of the things that you teach them, but make sure you do the right thing. Prepare them so that you have a free heart as they go. So somehow, let's look at the next one. So that's the end of the suggested remedies. I hope this lesson is really, really helping the teachers. And so please, involve your students so that they can listen and apply.